I'm Steve Brusati, and I've been asked to play Dinosaur in the Dark. I think it's going to be fun, maybe a little bit weird. Let's see. Okay. All right. The first thing I can say, this is not life-size. I can sense a long tail. I can sense a pretty long neck, kind of arched upwards, tiny little head, four legs. This thing would have walked on all fours, and it's got a pretty big gut. I think it has to be what we call a sauropod dinosaur, like a Brontosaurus or a Diplodocus or a Brachiosaurus, one of those long-necked, big-bellied, plant-eating dinosaurs. Okay, ooh, this is a different type. I'm grabbing onto something. It's like a fin. It seems to be like a sail on a sailboat or something. And that seems to be along the back of the animal. Yep, there's the tail. So that means that's the neck, that's the head. Ooh, tiny little arms. Not walking on his arms at all, but only walking on his hind legs. So this would have to be a meat-eating dinosaur, and it must be one of these things that we call a spinosaur. These meat-eaters, fish-eaters actually, that had these big sails on their back, maybe for display, or maybe actually to help them swim a little bit in the water when they were hunting fish. So I'm gonna go with Spinosaurus on this one. Ah, okay. I know what this is right away because it stabbed me. So this is a dinosaur that has two rows of sharp plates on its back, and each one ends kind of in a point at the top. So that means it has to be a stegosaur. So probably Stegosaurus itself is, you know, one of the most iconic dinosaurs. I can tell that the neck is not very long, and the head's pretty small, and the head's kind of pointed downwards. So that's a stegosaur thing. And if we go to the tail, yeah, there's a bunch of spikes on the tail. So the plates on the back and then these sharp spikes on the tail, those are stegosaur things. It probably would have used these spikes on the tail to defend itself from the big scary meat eaters that were always trying to eat it for lunch. Ooh, this is a big one. Oh my God, I mean, big hind legs, smaller arms, and actually decent sized arms. I couldn't have walked on these things. One, two, three, four claws. So, ooh, that's not gonna be a T-Rex. T-Rex only had two claws on his hands. It's not gonna be an Allosaurus that only had three claws. Quite a long tail though. You know, a head with some sharp teeth, but feels like a porcupine or something here. So I sense we're in the realm of movie magic maybe here. And I might be wrong because I don't know my monster movies as well as I should, but I think there's something a little bit Godzilla-y about this one. So I'm gonna go with Godzilla. And I hope this doesn't turn out to be an actual real dinosaur, because that would also mean I think my paleontology credentials need to be revoked. Well, this was all a little bit of fun, and I'm just glad I didn't completely embarrass myself. But it was fun, but also I think there's an educational thing here. You know, so many classrooms have toys like this, and these are things that, although they might look simple, they might look even a little bit kitschy, it's toys and books and films and television shows. This is what gets so many kids into science. And so I think we need to encourage this. And I think any classroom where there's toys like this, where kids have a little bit of time to take these dinosaurs, maybe even the occasional mammal, now forget about the mammal, and have these things battle each other and run around, play with each other, This is how most of us scientists, believe it or not, got started thinking about the mystery of what these things were like as real animals and envisioning the world hundreds of millions of years ago when these fantastic beasts actually lived on this very same planet that we live on now. Is that right? Is that Godzilla? Good. Nice try.